So this morning, I'm going to make one of my absolute favorite sandwich recipes. I'm going to make some pulled pork. Now, since pulled pork takes between 4 and 6 hours to make, mostly in cooking time, we want to get started right away in the morning. And right now it's, about 9 o'clock in the morning. So it's a great time to get this started. So let's start with the things that you need, which are actually pretty simple. First thing that you need is a pork shoulder roast. I actually had to go to a butcher here in Belgium and ask what in the world that is in Dutch, because I had no idea. Apparently, spieringgebraad is what you're looking for when you want to make something like pulled pork, and I've got a 1.2 kilo roast. I forget what the conversion is in pounds, but I think it's like half a pound, a little bit more than half a pound. So I've got my pork, and then I have my array of stuff that's going to go in the pork. So I've got seasonings and spices. I've got brown sugar. I've got cayenne pepper. I've got coriander. I've got paprika. I've got pepper and salt and cumin. I also have a couple of sort of veggie ingredients. I have one medium chopped onion and 5 cloves of garlic. I haven't chopped those because this is going to cook for so long that garlic's going to get nice and mushy. And then when we shred the pork, it's just going to mix in really nicely. And finally, I have some liquid here. Now, fruit juice, in my opinion, is the best way to make pulled pork. Some people use soda, like root beer, or Coca-Cola, or Dr. Pepper. I prefer a mixture of orange and apple juice. So I have 150 milliliters of orange juice, and then 100 milliliters of apple juice, which comes together to make about a cup of liquid, 250 milliliters of juice. So the first place that we have to start is making our rub or our spice mix. And the handy dandy part about this is you only need 2 spoons to do it. You need a tablespoon, which is 15 milliliter spoon, and you need a teaspoon, which is a 5 milliliter spoon. And it's just a matter of remembering which spices get which amount. So we start with our brown sugar, and that's gonna be a tablespoon spice. I'm gonna do the tablespoon spices first. Now normally when you do brown sugar, you pack it in, and we'll plop it into this bowl right here. Then I will do my cumin, so we'll get that out of the way. Cumin is also a 1 tablespoon spice. So we'll get a nice big fat spoonful of cumin, and I like extra cumin, so I didn't level off my scoop. And then finally we need a tablespoon of the paprika. So there we are, a tablespoon of paprika. Now those are all of my tablespoon spices. Now we're swapping out to a teaspoon. We will need a teaspoon of cayenne pepper. This will make it spicy. If you're not into spicy foods, you can actually just leave the cayenne pepper out. There we go, 1 teaspoon of cayenne pepper. Now it's time for our coriander. You can also use fresh coriander. I just don't happen to have any in the house. So I'm going to use a teaspoon of my flaky coriander. And we need a teaspoon of salt. This is just my sea salt here. Teaspoon of salt and a teaspoon of black pepper. Now, as you can see, I've got a grinder here, so I'm going to be estimating my teaspoon. And that looks like it's about right. And that's all the spices that I need. So I'm just going to take one of my spoons here and I'm going to mix this all together. Because what we're going to do is we're going to rub this all over our delicious pork. Now, there is a specific kind of pot that you need to do this. I've preheated my oven to quite a low temperature, actually, about 285 degrees Fahrenheit or 140 degrees Celsius. And the type of pot you need is an oven-safe pot. In this case, what I have is made of stainless steel, and it's all metal because obviously you can't put plastic in the oven, and it really needs to be able to be covered to trap moisture to make your pork nice and tender. Mine comes with an oven-safe lid, but you can also just use aluminum foil if you don't have an oven-safe lid. You can use a ceramic pot that's oven-safe. You can use a wrought iron pot that's oven-safe. I'm going to use steel today. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to throw in our onions, like a little bed for our pork. We'll add our garlic last. I'm just going to grab the pork here and I'm going to plop him into the pan. In you go. Now make sure that your hands are clean because you're going to be touching dead meat. And you want to make sure that there's no germies. We're going to sprinkle all of the spice rub into the bowl, and then we're going to make sure that we evenly coat the pork by turning it over and over again. It's going to get onions all over it. That's excellent. Now, almost last but not least, we're going to dump in our garlic cloves, our 5 garlic cloves. Oopsies. They can kind of go just at the bottom because they're going to cook in the liquid. And then finally, we're going to add our juice to the sides. There we go. Now this is basically ready to bake. I'm going to go ahead and cover it, and I'm going to put it into my preheated oven for about 4 hours, and then I'm going to come check it. If the pork easily falls apart, then it'll be finished. Otherwise, I'll bake it half an hour increments until I think that it's fully cooked. It's time to check the progress of our pulled pork. It's been about 4.5 hours in the oven. So what we're going to do is we're going to take off the lid and see what we've got. And now that the steam is cleared, we can see the fruits of our labor. We're going to use a couple of forks and we're going to try and pull the meat apart. If the meat comes apart very easily, like it is here, then that means our pork is finished and we can just keep pulling until we get bite-sized stringy pieces. And this meat is going to be perfect for sandwiches, for tacos. The cooking liquid can be used for sauces and for soups. And that, my friends, is pulled pork. Enjoy!